Hi, this is Deborah Saavedra with Legal Office Guru. And in today's video, we're going to go into Microsoft Word and actually demonstrate how to make your own styles. There are a couple of different ways to do this. One of them is a lot easier than the other one. But if you've decided that one of the over 200 Microsoft Word styles just isn't going to cut it for you in a particular application, then this is going to teach you how to actually create your own style. So stay tuned. If we've not met, I teach lawyers and other legal professionals how to use Microsoft Office better. So I'm going to share my screen now, just pause for just a moment and switch over to my screen sharing. And while I'm doing that, if you would let me know in the comments where you're watching from and whether you're seeing this live or whether you're seeing it in replay. I suspect a lot of you are going to be seeing it in replay because it's kind of early. And also whether you've seen the first three videos in the style series. Okay, so you should be seeing my screen right now. As I told you, there are two ways to create a new style in Microsoft Word, from scratch, you know, just completely, totally new, or from an example. And doing it from an example is really the easiest way to do this. If you can find or create an example of the formatting you want within your document, then you can first ask yourself the question, do I want to replicate character or paragraph formatting or both? Now, here's an example of paragraph formatting. This is actually deposition text. If you're quoting deposition text within the context of a pleading or brief, you probably want to indent it on both sides. You want to do a hanging indent, so you've got the Q and A kind of hanging out here and the other stuff indented. So I've got this text formatted the way that I want it. I'm going to select one of these paragraphs and then right click and choose styles. Now, just a note for you who are still using Microsoft Word 2007 or 2010, this menu is going to look a little bit different. You'll probably see it in here rather than up here by itself. But just note that the steps are going to be the same, that the menu may look a little bit different. But I'm going to click on styles here and do create a style. Now you're going to get a very simple dialog box where you can name it, and you could always click OK here, but I'm going to insist that you actually click that modify button, because there are some settings you probably are going to want to tweak here. Okay, first of all, I've named it. If you don't want this style to affect the font formatting in future documents, if you don't necessarily want it to pick up Calibri in a document that you've got formatted as Times New Roman, then you're going to want to change this setting. You're going to want to actually make this a paragraph style type rather than a linked style type. That way it's only picking up the paragraph settings, the indentation, the hanging indent, the line spacing, the space between, etc. That's all it's going to pick up. You can always make some other changes in the formatting in this dialog box. Somewhere in here, if it's something fairly straightforward. If you need to go to a different dialog box, you can do it here in that format. Now, if you want this style to be available in future documents, be sure to click this radio button next to New Documents Based on this template. If you want this style to show up in a Styles Gallery, be sure to make sure this box here next to Add to the Styles Gallery is checked, and that way it will show up here in the Styles Gallery. I generally discourage people from checking this Automatically Update box, because what that does is it updates the style every time you apply or anyone else applies direct formatting to text that's styled with this particular style. That can be devastating to the overall structure of your document. That can just introduce some chaos into it that really, unless you're very, very OCD about the way that you set up your styles, this to me just introduces too much chaos into the mix. Also, I forgot to go back over this. if you want to be able to, when you style a particular paragraph with depo text, and you want to be able to hit enter and continue in that same style, you want to be sure that that style is listed here, style for following paragraph. So that way you can continue entering in deposition text, and then when you're ready to switch back to normal or whatever you're using for your paragraph style, you can do that instead of having to go back and style every single paragraph. If it's going to be a situation in which you're going to be blocking and copying something from like a text document and dropping it into your pleading and then styling it as depo text all in one go, that may not be necessarily so important, but just be aware of that. I'm going to click OK here. And there's my deposition text style. So that's an example of how to create a style from an example that you already have in your text. You can also create a style completely from scratch if you know exactly what you want. Now, for example, I'm going to create a character-based style called citation. So I'm going to go to the styles area. This is on the home tab. Go to the styles area and click this more drop-down arrow and go down here to create a style. Again, I can name it here, but I probably want to tweak some of these settings in here. Again, I'm going to choose a style type. This time I'm going to do character, because all I want to do is to italicize the text. And click italics here. Now you're probably asking yourself, why would she go to the trouble of doing a style if all you want to do is italicize? I was experimenting yesterday with the possibility of suppressing spell check within a style. Wasn't quite able to get it to work, but if I do get it to work, I may post a video on doing that. But it is supposedly possible to suppress spell check within certain parts of your document based on the style. Haven't gotten it to work yet. So that was one reason I wanted to create a character style called citation. Again, if I want to add it to the styles gallery, I make sure that that's checked. If I want to do this in future documents based on this, then I make sure I check that radio button, and I can do some other formatting type things in here if I want to. By the way, that suppress spell check is here. Like I said, couldn't get that to work yesterday when I was doing my practice run. So I'm going to click OK. And there is my citation format. So if I start typing something, and then I can select that, and then use citation. So that's it. That's how you create a new style in Microsoft Word. So we're coming in at under 13 minutes this morning, but that was a quick and dirty on how to actually create styles in Word. If you will, in the comments below, tell me what sorts of styles questions you have, what kinds of things that maybe you've applied from some of the earlier lessons in this series and are maybe having some difficulties with, or some things that you're curious about whether or not you can actually do those things within styles. Let me know what you have questions about in the comments, and we will wrap it up here. Let me go over here and see if there are any questions at the moment, and there aren't, so I'm going to wrap it up here. It was good to see you guys this morning. Hope this was useful. If you do have any questions, be sure to leave those in the comments below, and I'll dip in and see if I can answer those. But have a good Thursday, and I will check you guys next week.